فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Please repeat after me. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. السلام عليكم. Beautiful sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as Allah Azzawajal mentions in the glorious Quran, the way the kuffar used to listen to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Ta'ala has mentioned that in the Quran. مَا يَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ مُحْدَثٍ إِلَّا اسْتَمَعُوهُ وَهُمْ يَلْعَبِرُونَ لَاهِيَةَ الْقُلُوبِ. That is the way the kuffar used to listen to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not paying that attention. They would listen to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then they would walk off. For the Muslims, it's very important that we sit down and we concentrate on what we are going to learn. Every sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and every word of the Quran has a very deep understanding and a very deep meaning. If you look around and you're not paying attention, we might lose the benefits and the blessings. So, Pyare Shahbhaiyo, jitne bhi buzurg Islami bhai hain, the kids as well, barai karam, tawajjuh ke saath hum inshaAllah azza wa jal bayan sunenge, iski barakatein inshaAllah azza wa jal hamein haasil hongi. Alhamdulillah, we learn about sending durood and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. There is a beautiful narration that once Bani Israel, someone died in their tribe. Bani Israel ka ek shakhs jo tha, uska intiqal ho gaya. And people took his body and they threw it in a rubbish truck. جہاں کچرا لوگ دیتے تھے اس کو اسی کچرے میں ڈال دیا. اللہ عز و جل, he sends a revelation to موسیٰ علیہ السلام, او موسیٰ, go to the certain tribe of Bani Israel, people have thrown one of their persons into the rubbish truck. او موسیٰ, go and give ghusl to him and offer his janaza and bury him respectfully. Musa alayhi salam, he went and he recognized it. Us bande ko pehchan liya ki ye to bada gunahgar shakhs tha, isse itna bada rupya kaise bhej diya. So Musa alayhi salam, he offered, he gave ghusl to him, he offered his janaza, he buried him, and then he made a dua in the court of Allah azza wa jal. Oh Allah, for what reason was this person given this high status? اس بندے نے یا اللہ کون سا ایسا عمل کیا ہے جس کی وجہ سے یا اللہ تو نے مجھے حکم دیا ہے کہ میں اس کا جنازہ پڑھوں اسے دفن کروں. تو اللہ عز و جل سے جو موسیٰ علیہ السلام, one day this man he was reading the Torah and in the Torah he was reading the name of my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and then out of love and respect he kissed the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rubbed it on his eyes. Because of the adab he gave to my Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have forgiven all his sins.
Brothers, red Mitsubishi blocking the driveway outside. If there's somebody with a red Mitsubishi, because someone has to leave urgently, could you please remove the red Mitsubishi vehicle? Zaka, zaka.
صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. پیارے صاحب بھائیو, as Muslims, one of the most important aspects of our deen is love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. اعلی حضرت رحمت اللہ تعالی علیہ says, وہ جو نہ تھے تو کچھ نہ تھا, وہ جو نہ ہو تو کچھ نہ ہو, جان ہے وہ جہان کی, جان ہے تو جہان. So the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he is the life of this universe. And for us to be a Muslim, the first and the most important thing is that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And how much should we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Sometimes the shaitan will whisper in your mind, this is how much we should love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Isse zyada hame nahi jana chahiye. This is how much you should love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then that is it. Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned in the Quran, love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And one day Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was holding the hand of Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and he says, O Umar, do you love me? And Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, what can you imagine? Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Umar loves you more than anything in this world apart from his life. یعنی اپنی جان کے علاوہ یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم ہر چیز سے زیادہ عمر آپ سے محبت کرتا ہے. And the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, he says, O Umar, your iman is still not complete. And then سیدنا عمر رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, he says, یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, when is my iman going to be complete? And the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, he says, O Umar, your iman will be complete when you love me more than your own life as well. یعنی مجھ سے اپنی جان سے بھی زیادہ جب تم محبت کرو گے تمہارا ایمان مکمل ہوگا. تو پیارے اسلام بھائیو, when you think about this, when you think about loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than your own life, then what comes into mind? That whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or however the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants to me live my life, I will live my life accordingly. اب جس طرح حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا حکم ہے, پیارے اسلام بھائیو, اگر میں مسلمان ہوں, میں اپنے آقا علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کو اپنی جان سے بھی زیادہ محبت کرتا ہوں, اب جو بھی میرے آقا صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا حکم ہے میرے لبیک کہے گا. I'm not going to think twice. I'm not going to think twice that should I do this or should I not do this? Should I act upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or should I leave it? What was the most important things from the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Sahaba ikram ki agar hum zindagi dekhein, how did the Sahaba ikram live? Wo hai pyare aqa e salatu wassalam se kis had tak mohabbat karte the. In one battle, Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, she notices a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seriously wounded lying on the ground. Itne zakhmi ke khoon beh raha tha. Pyare aqa e salatu wassalam ka wo اس کے خون بہ رہا تھا. سیدہ عائشہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ, she went close to him and she could hear that companion سیدنا زید رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ, he was uttering these words. یہ الفاظ آپ کی زبان سے تھے, آہ, I wish if someone can go and let the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم know that his lover, his عاشق زید is about to leave this world. کہ ان کا عاشق دنیا چھوڑ کر جا رہا ہے. سیدہ عائشہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ, she goes running to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of your ashiks, Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu, is very, very badly injured. Ya Rasulullah, he has a few moments to live. Ya Rasulullah, he is calling out your name. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, aapka ghulam aapko bula raha. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he immediately, he runs and he comes to the aid of Sayyidina Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He sees him, his eyes are closed and he's lying on the ground. Blood is flowing through his body. Sayyidina Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sits down next to him. He takes his head and he puts it on his lap. And then he strokes his forehead and he says, O Zayd, open your eyes, look, I am here. وہ کتنے خوش قسمت تھے کہ آقا علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام ان کے سرانے آگے اپنا ہاتھ ان کے ماتھے پر پھیرا. زید آنکھیں کھولو, میں آگے آ گیا. اے زید تم آنکھیں کھولو. سیدنا زیاد رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ looked at the beauty of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم and then because of so losing so much blood he was very weak and then he tried to gather all his strength in his body and then he dragged himself and he placed his head in the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yaar ya Allah salatu wassalam ke kadmon mein apna sar rakh diya. Indian. I am happy for Allah to be my creator. I am happy for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be my prophet. Aur phir is zor se aapne nara lagaya fustu rabbil kaaba rabbe kaaba ki qasam aaj main kamyab ho gaya. He was successful. Why did he say he was successful? Because he died in the feet of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Apni jaan ko qurban kar diya. This is what, my dear Islamic brothers, what we call love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Aaj pyare Islami bhaiyo, ishq-e rasool ka ye sirf matlab nahi hai ki hum sirf zubani ye kahe ki main apne aqa e salat ko salam se mohabbat karta hu. Are hamara rehna sehna, hamari bol chaal, hamara logon se len den, ye sab kuch bataye ki ye waqai aashiq-e rasool hai. Everything should be apparent. Everything should be in front of us, and then when people look at us, then they will realize, yes, he loves the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Isko pyare Islam bhaiyo, iske rasool kehte hain. Aur sahaba ikram ki agar hum zindagiyan dekhein, sahaba ikram alaihim ridwan pyare aqa e salat wa salam se itni mohabbat karte the that whenever they would hear the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say anything to them, the sahaba ikram wouldn't think twice. The sahaba ikram would immediately follow the command of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's look at the life of Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala. Do we know what Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala went with? You know, we alhamdulillah, we were born in a Muslim home. Humne Islam ke liye humne itna qurbani di hai. Humne koi dua nahi ki thi. Lekin Allah ta'ala ne itna humne ehsaan kiya ke ek Musliman ke ghar mein humne paida kiya. Lekin pyare Islam bhaiyo, let's look at the lives of these companions. Zara in sahaba ikram ki hum zindagiyan dekhein. In sahaba ikram ne apni zindagi sari islam ki khatir pyare aqa e salat wa salam ki aisi mohabbat thi. Are jaan dene ke liye sahaba ikram taiyar rehte the. But never did the sahaba ikram ever said to the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam that ya Rasulullah, this is too hard for us. Ya Rasulullah, we've got families to look after. Ya Rasulullah, we have work to look after. Now this sahaba ikram, they proved that whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and the true ashiq rasul will be the one who says the bait at every saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was a slave, one day he was sat, and the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam walked past him and saw that Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was turning a chakki, is tarah aata pees rahe hain. Bukhar aur jo hai wo bukhar ke mare, dard ke mare, is tarah aapki, yani jisse dard hota hai na, is tarah Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, these were the expressions on his face. And the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he looked at him. And at that time, Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu didn't know who he was. So the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he went to him and he says, what's your name? And he says, my name is Bilal. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that you look so ill, you have a high temperature. Why don't you leave this world? Thodi der kaam chhod do, aur aaram kyun kar lete. And he says that my master, if I leave this world, my master, he will hit me. He will whip me if I leave this world. He has given me this world and I need to finish this world. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam again, when he started looking at Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he could see the pain that Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu was going through. He looked at him and he says, move to one side. Let me do your work. Let me do your work. And he says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sat next to Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he started doing his work. Is tarah aap chakki peeste jaate, Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu kabhi apni taraf dekhte, kabhi aqa e salat wa salam ke pyare chehre ko dekhte, aur phir apne khayal mein sochte, who is this person and why is he helping me? People in here, I have such a status that people swear at me, people hit me, but who is this person who is helping me today? Arre log to mujhe gaaliyan dete hain, ye kaun hai jo aaj mera kaam karne ke liye aaye hain? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he was doing the work of Sayyidina Bilal radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when he finished, he says to Bilal that go and tell your master that your work is finished. And Sayyidina Bilal radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, at least tell me who you are. Why did you help me? People don't respect me at all. I am a slave. People hit me. They don't think of me as anything. Who are you and you help me? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, my name is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he has heard of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's heard of the status and what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what his message was. And then, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was about to leave, Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, O Prophet of Allah, please accept me in your religion. And he accepted Islam. My dear Islam brothers, then after that, uske baad Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, ki zindagi kaise guzri? The struggles he went through for the sake of Islam. Islam ki khatir Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu ne kitni musibatein sahi hain. What have we struggled for Islam? What have we done that we have been given our lives for the sake of Islam? We haven't done anything. But let's look at the lives of these companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What they did for Islam, how much of love they had for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went and he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was hungry. He went up to him and he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you look to be hungry. Ya Rasulullah, Pyare Aqa alaihi salam wa salam, he replied, Ay mere sahabi radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, 3 din ho chuke, maine kuch khana nahi khaya. I am very hungry. And this Ashiq Rasul of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, foran gaye, pura din mehnat karte rahe. Pyare Aqa alaihi salatu wa salam ki barkah mein kuch khujure pesh kiye. Kaha ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, aap in khujuron ko khaye. To Pyare Aqa alaihi salatu wa salam ne ek sawal pucha, ae mere sahabi, tumne ye sab kuch kyun kiya hai? وہ صحابی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ رو کر کہتے ہیں یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم میں آپ سے محبت کرتا ہوں آقا میں نے جب دیکھا کہ آپ بھوکے یا رسول اللہ مجھے یہ برداشت نہیں ہو سکا میں گیا میں نے کام کیا محنت کی یا رسول اللہ یہ کھجوریں فرما کر لایا ہوں آقا آپ انہیں قبول فرما دیجئے پیارے آقا علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام نے اس صحابی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ سے کہا if you love me if you are true to your statement and you say that you love me, then be prepared that those who love me, problems and calamities will come to them faster than water runs down a mountain. Pyare Sahabi Bhaiyo, when we say that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just for a moment, just wait. Just ask yourself, do I really love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And if I do love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how is my life today? Pyare Aqa Ali Salatu Wasalam, he says that a true Muslim is he. Whatever he likes for himself, he will like for his brother. Jo apne liye pasand karta hai, apne bhai ke liye bhi wo pasand karta hai. Pyare Islam bhaiyo, I want a good life. I want a good home. I want everything. I want all the facilities. I want all the amenities for my life. But when I see my Muslim brothers, when I see them dancing away in the nightclubs, when I see my own Muslim brothers dying with hunger, when I see my own Muslim brothers dying with thirst, they can't even get water to drink. And look at my lifestyle. Look at my lifestyle. And look at the lifestyle of these poor Muslims. Lekin Pyare Islami Bhaiyo, have we ever thought to ourselves, just for one moment, think to yourself, this gift, this ni'mat that Allah Ta'ala has given me, I have to answer for this on the Day of Judgment. Pyare Aqa Alaihi Salatu Wasalam, he says that a Muslim is he who will love his brother only for the sake of Allah. Only for the sake of Allah. Ye nahi hai ki ye fula musliman se main isliye mohabbat karta hu, iske paas daulat zyada hai, ye bada khoobsurat hai, iski awaaz achhi hai, ye bada respectful hai, log community mein se jante hain, main isse mohabbat karunga. Nahi, Pyare Aqa Alaihi Salatu Wasalam, he says, love someone for the sake of Allah. And if you have hatred for someone, only that hatred for the sake of Allah. Aaj, main usse muhabbat karta hun. Why do I love him? Do I love him because of his status? No. I should love him because he's a Muslim. I should love him because he reads the kalima of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Lekin aaj, Pyare Islam bhaiyo, kya aaj bhai bhai se nahi utha hua? Kya aaj maa apni beti se nahi uthi hui? Kya baap apne bete se nahi utha hua? Wajah kya? Wajah yahi hai. Baap is liye utha hua hai. Beta kama kar kuch nahi la raha. Maa beti se isliye ruji hui hai because she doesn't listen to it. And this is the problem we are having in our own families. And because of these problems, my dear Islam brothers, let's go back to the root of what our iman, what our Islam is. Our Islam, the root of our Islam. Islam is that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jab ek banda pyare aqa alaihi salatu wassalam se mohabbat karega to wo banda apne bhai se bhi mohabbat karega. He will love his family, he will love his children, he will love his parents. Aur aaj pyare sahab bhaiyo, we say that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's our own family, our own community. Do you know what is happening today? Aaj pyare sahab bhaiyo, let's look at the parents, those youngsters who are sat here. Let's look at the parents. What is the status of our parents today? What is the state of our parents today? Let me tell you. Do you know we used to have care homes? There's loads of care homes in this country. But now there are care homes opening up in this own country. And in them care homes, there is no kafir living there, there are Muslims living there. Ya Musliman is care home mein rehte. Ek waqia sunata hu. Let me tell you a story about someone who went into this care home. He was a counselor. Counselor the. Unka aana jana us care home mein hua. وہاں پر ایک دن گئے تو دیکھا ایک بزرگ. I've told this story many times for ibrat, so that we can learn, so that we can look at ourselves, where we are going, where are we going wrong. وہ کہتے ہیں میں اس کیئر ہوم میں گیا. ایک پاکستانی مسلمان بزرگ وہاں اس کیئر ہوم میں داخل ہوئے. ان سے پوچھا گیا کہ حضور کیا وجہ ہے, کیا آپ کیا جب آپ کی دیکھ بھال کرنے کے لیے کوئی نہیں ہے آپ کی فیملی میں؟ تو وہ بزرگ رو کر کہتے ہیں میرا اپنا بیٹا اسی شہر میں رہتا ہے لیکن میں اب بوڑھا ہو گیا ہوں, مجھے کھانسی کی پرابلم ہے, میں رات کو کھانستا تھا. یہ اس بزرگ کا, یہ خود کا بیان ہے کہ مجھے رات کو کھانسی ہوتی تھی. میرا بیٹا ایک مرتبہ آیا میرے پاس اور کہتا ابا تم رات کو اتنا کھانستے ہو میں سو نہیں سکتا. میری بیوی اور بچے بھی کمپلین کرتے تھے, کمپلین اباؤٹ یو. سو دیٹس وہ ریلی آئی ایم گونا ٹیک یو ٹو ا کیئر ہوم, میں تمہیں کیئر ہوم چھوڑ کر آؤں گا. تو پیارے صاحب بھائیو وہ بزرگ جو تھے تین دن اس کیئر ہوم میں انہوں نے گزارے, تین دن. All this goes back to the love of the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. تین دن اس کیئر ہوم میں گزارے. ایک دن وہ کاؤنسلر نے اپنا نمبر دیا تھا کہ اگر ان بزرگوں کو کوئی تکلیف ہو آپ مجھ سے رابطہ کریں. کیوں؟ کہ وہ کہتے جناب اس کا بیٹا آیا تھا, اس نے پیپر فل کیا, نمبر دیا, ہم نے کتنی مرتبہ ٹرائی کیا, وہ فون نہیں اٹھا رہا, فون نہیں اٹھا رہا. اب ابو نے اسے فون کیا کاؤنسلر کو اور کہا کہ جب سے یہ آئے ہیں ایک دن بھی انہوں نے صحیح طرح کھانا نہیں کھایا, یہ کھانا نہیں کھاتے. تو وہ کاؤنسلر جو تھا ہی went back there, واپس گئے اس کیئر ہوم میں, اس بزرگ سے پوچھا کہ بابا جی وجہ کیا ہے, کھاتے کیوں نہیں ہیں, آپ نے کھانا پینا بند کیوں کر دیا؟ تو پتہ ہے بزرگ کیا کہتے ہیں؟ کہتے ہیں کہ آجی صاحب میں کس طرح کھاؤں, یہ وہی پلیٹس ہیں, سور کا گوشت بھی اسی پلیٹ میں آتا ہے, میرا کھانا بھی اسی پلیٹ میں آتا ہے, اور میں سور کا گوشت کس طرح کھاؤں؟ ذرا سوچیں. That could be our parents in that care home. تین دن کے بعد کاؤنسلر کو پھر فون آیا, جلدی سے ہسپتال پہنچے, بیٹے کو ہم فون کر چکے وہ فون ہی نہیں اٹھا رہا, آپ جلدی سے پلیز پہنچے, he's very serious, بہت سیریس ہے وہ. کاؤنسلر کہتے ہیں میں گیا اس کیئر ہوم میں, دیکھا کہ وہ بزرگ ہی وہ لائف سپورٹ مشین, and they were going to take him to the hospital. ابھی وہ جا رہے تھے ان کی, جب مجھے دیکھا ان کی آنکھیں کھل گئی ہیں, اس طرح آنسو ان کی آنکھوں سے گر پڑے, اس طرح وہ آنکھوں سے آنسو گر پڑے. تو میں نے سوچا he was trying to say something and I asked the nurses can I go with him to the hospital and the nurses said that yes you can. وہ کاؤنسلر کہتے ہیں میں ان کے ساتھ ہسپتال میں گیا. جب ہسپتال میں پہنچا تو جب ان کا ٹریٹمنٹ شروع ہوا وہ اور زیادہ سیریس ہوئے, تو کہنا چاہتے ہیں. اور جب انہوں نے وہ ماسک کو کہتے ہیں تھوڑی دیر کے لیے میں نے پرے کر اس طرح ہاتھ رکھ دیا, وہ بزرگ کہتے ہیں میرے بیٹے کو بلا لو, مجھے اپنے پوتے کی ایک مرتبہ زیارت ہو جائے, میں بڑا گھبرا گیا, یا مجھے اتنے دن ہو چکے ہیں میں بس اپنے بیٹے کو دیکھنا چاہتا ہوں. تو وہ کاؤنسلر کہتا ہے میں نے بیٹے کو فون کیا, اس نے فون اٹھایا, میں نے کہا ہسپتال والے کتنی مرتبہ تمہیں فون کرتے رہے, وائی ڈیڈ یو ناٹ پک یور فون؟ تو کہتا ہے میں بزی ہوں, میں کام پر بزی ہوں, آئی رنگ یو لیٹر. بعد میں جب کاؤنسلر کہتے ہیں کہ میں نے باپ سے کہا کہ, وہ کہتا ہے میں بزی ہوں, تو وہ والد صاحب کہتے ہیں جب اس نے یہ سنا ان کے سانس اس طرح بڑی مشکل سے سانس لینے لگے اور تھوڑی دیر کے بعد دنیا سے چلے گئے. آج پیارے صاحب ہم کہتے ہیں ہم عاشق رسول ہیں, ارے ہم عاشق رسول ہوتے تو پیارے صاحب بھائیو یہ سب سے بڑی نعمت جو ہمارے پاس ہے ہمارے والدین, ڈاکٹر صاحب کہتے ہیں کہ والدہ کا انتقال ہوا، ہمارے والدین کا بھی انتقال ہوا، لیکن جن کے والدین ہیں ذرا سوچیں، میں آج اپنے والدین سے کتنی محبت، ایک طرف میں کہتا ہوں میں عاشق رسول ہوں، میں اپنی جان پیارے آقا علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کے لیے دے سکتا ہوں. Can you, you know, you can't even give time to our own parents. There was an interview, someone sent me a link, and in that link, they were interviewing a very old woman. Ek buri khatoon wheelchair mein baithi hui thi. Unse interview le rahe the. Wo bechari keh rahi thi interview dete dete wo rone lagi. Ro rahi hai, zara fikar ho rahi hai. پھر تھوڑی دیر بعد جب افاقہ ہوتا ہے تو وہ انٹرویو کرنے والا ان سے پوچھتا ہے کہ ماں جی آپ کا بیٹا کبھی آپ سے ملنے کے لیے آتا ہے؟ This is another old woman in a care home. وہ کہتی ہے ہر اتوار کو میرا بیٹا کہتا تھا میں آؤں گی، میں آؤں گا. کہتے ہیں ہر اتوار کو میں دروازے کی طرف تکتی ہوں، میرا بیٹا نہیں آتا. ذرا سوچیں اسی ماں کے دل میں کیا گزر رہی ہوگی جب وہ اپنے بیٹے کا راستہ دیکھ رہی ہے. ایک اور جگہ پر ایک انٹرویو تھا، these are real life stories I'm telling you about. An interview of an old man and an old woman. Both of them walking on the streets of Lahore. لاہور کی سڑکوں پر وہ دونوں بھیک مانگ کر کھانا کھا رہے تھے. کسی نے انٹرویو لیا کہ آپ یہاں لاہور کیوں بھیک مانگتے ہیں؟ I've seen you for a few days. Why are you on the streets of Lahore? اس بزرگ نے جواب دیا ہم کوئی لاوارث نہیں ہیں، ہم کوئی ایسا نہیں ہے، ہمارا کوئی نہیں ہے، اسی شہر میں میرے چار بیٹے رہتے ہیں، بڑے بڑے بنگلے میں رہتے ہیں، جو کل میرے بنگلے تھے آج میرے بیٹے ان بنگلوں میں رہتے ہیں، ہم آج سڑک پر آ گئے. کہا بابا جی وجہ کیا ہے، کیا ہوا؟ کہتے ہیں کہ میں جب بوڑھا ہو گیا میں نے سوچا میری اولاد جوان ہو گئی ہے. ایوری ون آج یہی سوچتے ہیں نا، اولاد جوان ہو گئی ہے، چلو ان کے لیے ان کا مکان تلاش کرو، ان کی شادی کرو تاکہ میں ریٹائر ہو کر آرام سے زندگی گزاروں گا. وہ بابا جی کہتے ہیں میرے ذہن میں بھی یہی تھا کہ میں بھی بچوں کی شادیاں کر دوں گا، آرام سے اپنی زندگی گزاروں گا، دونوں میاں بیوی کی ہماری اولاد دیکھ بھال کرے گی. کہتے ہیں کہ ہم چھوٹے بیٹے کے ساتھ رہنے لگے، ساری جائیداد میں نے اپنے بیٹوں کے نام کر دی اور پھر چھوٹے بیٹے کے ساتھ رہنے لگا. کچھ ہی دن گزرے تھے کہ بیٹا ہم سے تنگ آ گیا، اس نے دوسرے بھائی کے پاس بھیج دیا، اس نے تیسرے کے پاس بھیج دیا، اس نے چوتھے کے پاس بھیج دیا. آخر تنگ آ کر ایک دن بڑے بیٹے نے بھی ہم سے کہا کہ ابا جی آپ بہت برے ہو چکے ہیں، آپ ہمارے لیے ماشاء اللہ مصیبت بن چکے ہیں، کبھی ایک اپوائنٹمنٹ ختم نہیں ہوتی، کبھی دوسری اپوائنٹمنٹ پہ جانا ہے. تو پپا جی بہتر یہی ہے آپ گھر سے نکل جائیں، جو کرنا ہے وہ کریں. دونوں میاں بیوی سڑک پر بھیک مانگ کر آج گزارا کر رہے ہیں. And then we say we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's look at our lives. How do I be as a Muslim? I say I love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when it comes to action, I am nowhere to be seen. My, it's only on the lips, my dear Islam brothers. I'm very sorry to say that, including myself as well. It's only on the lips that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Aaj hamari lifestyle mein kya hai? Our lifestyle tells us that we do love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it's only when it feels like ہوتا ہے یار، when I feel like میرا موڈ نہیں ہے آج، آج میرا موڈ نہیں ہے نماز پڑھنے کا، معاذ اللہ یہ آج کل الفاظ کہہ رہے ہیں، میرا موڈ نہیں ہے نماز پڑھنے کا، آج یار موڈ نہیں ہے مسجد جانے کا، آج یار موڈ نہیں ہے اس چیز کا. ارے ہمارا دین موڈ پر نہیں ہے. Our look at the Sahaba Ikram who gave their lives for the sake of Islam, and we are looking at our moods today. This is why we are having problems seriously. We need to wait for it. We need to wake up and we need to realize, my dear Islamic brothers. And the first thing that we look is that we look at our own selves today. How we treat our own brothers. Aaj aap ek baap hum apne bhai se kis tarah milte hain? Hum ek musliman ko salam bhi karte hain ya nahi? Aaj kitne salam karte hain? Aaj aap maaz Allah sab kismati ke saath aaj salam usse kiya jata hai jisko hum jante hain. We don't give salam. And that is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he says that when my nation they stop giving salam, they will have problems in the community. And we are having problems today seriously. But we don't want to discuss these problems. We don't want to talk about these problems. Why? Because we're scared. Ek nojwan sir mein ek baat us karta hu. Who doesn't know listening to films and songs is haram? Who doesn't know that? Everyone knows that. When we have the non-Muslims making a mockery of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it hurts our feelings. When someone makes a mockery of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hum kya karte hain? Julus nikalte hain. Lekin pyare Islami bhaiyo, aaj unhi ki filmein hamare ghar mein chalti hain, nahi chalti. There are films we play them in our own homes. Aaj we say today, we're going to free Kashmir. Then every Indian film is in my house. We say that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We don't like those. We hate those. Those are our enemies who are mocking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam today. Yet every English film is in my house. How can I say that I love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So many other issues that are in our community, and we say we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Seriously, my dear Islam brothers, if we do not change, and it's time that we change now. It's time that we understood. We understood our status as a Muslim, and we change ourselves. हम आज खुद बदलेंगे. दूसरे की तरफ ना देखें. वो नमाज नहीं पढ़ता. वो शराब का कारोबार करता है. वो ये करता है. वो करता है. अरे अपने तरफ देखें. Look at yourself, children, and then think to yourself: When I die, when I am buried inside the grave, when the question will be asked, ما كنت تقول في حفي هذا الرجل. Will I lift my head up and say that yes, he is my beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Or will I be hiding my face? How can I show my face to him? How can I show my face to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I never lived a life according to his teaching. How are we going to say this? Now it's time. Look at our younger generation that is growing up today. Our younger generation sadly today don't know the history of Islam, don't know the family names of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they grow up, what they want to tell their own children? So, pyare Islam bhaiyo, when we come and celebrate the Milad of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the main and the most important thing that we celebrate Milad is that we learn about the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We learn the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we try to change ourselves. May Allah Azza wa Jalla reward us all, and may Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive our sins. Let's go back from this ijtima today. Aaj hum yahan se jab wapas jaye, I'm going to be a changed person. I do not like those kuffar who made a mockery of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now I will stand up to that, and I will say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I love you and I can give my life for you, but Ya Rasulullah, I am going to change myself. I am going to act upon your sunnahs. Once we start doing that, once these sunnahs are implemented in our lives, then my dear Islam brothers, you will change, see a change in the community. Warna kya hoga? Ijtimaat hote rahenge, lekin main badla nahi. Pyare Islam bhaiyo, how is this world going to change? Please, it's time that we change ourselves. May Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive us all. There's not enough time. But Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jalla, we're going to, these nats, the brothers will be reciting. The only reason why the nats are being recited so that the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is increased in our hearts. And inshallah Azza wa Jalla, let's listen to them in such a manner that when I go back, before when I came, now when I leave these masjids, I will have so much love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that this love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will inshallah start showing on my physical body as well. Inshallah. Ameen bijahe Nabiyyil Amin sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam.